Welcome back to Writer's World Radio, episode 17. I am refutably your host, Matthew Graykin. I hope everyone's doing well today. Your spring is going well. If you're in the Southern Hemisphere, your fall's going well. Up here, it's rainy, it's cold, it's sunny, it's hot. It's great at being in New Jersey. That's what we pay all these high taxes for. So today, I want to talk to you about an author. I'm going to go back to an author selection. Someone that most of us know his works, but primarily we know him from the movies, not necessarily from the writings. I'm talking about the one, the only, his birthday is at the end of this month, Mr. Ian Fleming. So, born Ian Lancaster Fleming on the 28th of May, 1908. He was the son of a parliament member. His dad was very influential in the financing game. He himself didn't want to do too much with it. He was very much a playboy. But moving on, he eventually was hired into the Royal Navy. The Royal Navy Reserves picked him up. The Rear Admiral wanted him as his personal assistant. Now, if you do your research, a lot of you will find he had no experience, no actual qualifications to hold such a job, but managed to land it anyway. Was it his smooth talking? Was it his writing abilities? Who knows? But this is how he got into the job. And he made his way during World War II. He became a very important member. He started Unit 30, which was a special forces group. He actually wrote up plans on how to try and catch the Enigma device. Also, he came up with the idea of tricking the German soldiers by, as disturbing as this may sound, during war, you gotta do what you gotta do. He would take, they would put false plans on pieces of paper, sticking them in bottles, attaching them to the corpses of dead soldiers, tossing them overboard from boats or sinking, scuttling ships, small ships, for the Germans to find, kind of like a red herring. That would tell the Germans to do one thing, and the Allied troops would be ready to catch them, versus what the actual plans were. So he was very influential for the Royal Navy. He also later on formed a group called T-Force, another special forces group. He even laid the blueprints with FDR. FDR worked with him to create what would eventually become our CIA in the United States. So this guy, he had a lot of ingenuity coming to the military mind, not being from a military background. So that's the interesting part. So he was an officer, he became a lieutenant commander in the Royal Navy, much like somebody else, much like his protagonist. He even helped with the Special Forces Operation GoldenEye, which was keeping Special Forces in Spain while the before the German army would try and occupy it, to keep communications open, find out what's going on, and sabotage certain effects. This is all what led to James Bond. Once out of the army, he became a journalist. He worked for a number of papers and settled down with his wife, got married, and wrote his first book, Casino Royale. And a lot of his friends, close friends, personal friends, ex-girlfriends, told him, this book's no good. Don't publish it, or publish it under a pseudonym. So that way, if people don't like it, well, you can get away that way. You're not going to hear about it. But that's not the case. He believed in his writing. So Ian Fleming decided to publish Casino Royale. And the popularity of that book took off. A lot of people loved it. So he kept on writing more and more Bond novels based on, a lot of these things were based on his military experiences. fantasy to an extent, maybe exaggerating. But at the same time, nevertheless, he took the experiences that he had in the Royal Navy and applied them to one of the world's most favorite spies. To create one of his most favorite spies. A lot of it comes into it. You know, the womanizing, his love of cars, all got created into this character. So he went on to write 14 other novels for James Bond, becoming one of the top selling spy novels in the world, one of the top selling novel series in the world. He even wrote the children's book, Chitty Chitty Bang Bang. I mean, who doesn't love a little Benny Hill and Dick Van Dyke, huh? I mean, that movie also, you know, another novel of his put into a movie. He even wrote some travel books. So he wasn't just limited to fictional writing. This is a writer who was very diverse in his writing. Between, again, journals, newspaper writing, financial works, military papers, spy novels, travel writing, children books. So there was a lot that he did. He worked very closely when the movies finally, the books started becoming movies. He did work with the Broccoli family to make sure that things were done correctly. So there you go, Ian Fleming. I mean, a fantastic writer, very interesting. Whenever you really start to learn about what he's done and how he got to that point. So, again, you never know where your life may take you with your writing and what kind of experiences in your past you could put into your future writing. Hope you enjoyed the episode. Where are some of your favorite James Bond novels? Or you can't think of which novel? What's your favorite movie? Who do you think makes the best James Bond? Leave it in the comments below. Tweet it out. Or put it on Facebook. Use the hashtag WritersWorldRadio. Hit me up on Twitter at Matthew J. Graykin, or join us on the Facebook at facebook.com/MatthewJGraykin. I hope all of you are doing well. I hope your writing's coming along well. Just remember, it all starts with one word. One word now on a piece of paper will just begin the journey in your mind and in your heart to create that book, that short story, that poem, whatever you're trying to create. It all begins with that one word. 10 minutes a day, 5 minutes a day, whatever you could put. If you could just write one sentence a day. By the end of the week, you can have a paragraph. 2 weeks, two paragraphs. Then you have a couple pages. Don't give up. You may think you don't have time. It doesn't take a lot of time. Keep at it. If you need help, contact me. I'm always willing to help out. You know, I face these struggles too sometimes. Just believe in yourself. And stay positive. It will happen. Again, I hope everyone's doing well. I hope you're going to enjoy the rest of your summer. And between now and then, think about some other authors that you admire. Let me know who they are. Maybe we'll talk about it. Maybe I'll talk about it on this video cast, on the podcast. And until then, I'll see you next time.
Expect me to talk?
No, Mr. Bond, I expect you to die.